Patti came into Border Collie Rescue care through Easingwell Council Dog Warden Services in April 2006. She'd been found tied to a caravan, background unknown. She was about a year old and painfully thin. Her 7 days in the council pound were up, and she remained unclaimed, facing euthanasia. The pound manageress, Joan Hunter, told us, "This dog's too good to be put to sleep," and held on to Patti until we found the space.
Looking out for love in the night so still. Oh, how build you kingdom in that house on the hill. Looking out for love.
She assessed as a non-worker around sheep. She showed too much prey instinct, more instinct to chase than to herd. She had very long legs and a long nose, timid, rather scared of people, but grew in confidence as more and more people in Border Collie Rescue handled her. Her natural tendencies lent towards ground and air scenting, and this, combined with her ability to jump up and reach into hidden areas, finding the ball each time, gave us an indication for her future. She was tenacious, loyal and good-natured, and just loved to run free.
Looking out for love.
The thing that sometimes people forget, they forget where we actually got the dog from. The dog's point of view, coming to Border Collie Rescue with all that land and space and people that spoke the same language was such a wonderful place to go to.
Yeah.
It might not be the wonderful luxury home she has now, but it was such an improvement from where she was.
Well, when we went to Scarborough Trail and we went down to the beach at Bogle Hall, I don't know whether you've heard of that beach anyway, and there was about 12 dogs. And they were all just off the lead, running, you know. And of course, she loves water. She just goes and jumps in the cattle trough. After we've done any work, she just goes and sits in the water.
Yeah, that's nice.
You know.
Just chills out.
So, and I just said to my friend, I said, "Hey, I wonder what she's thinking. Mm. You know, I'm running here.
Yeah.
You know, absolutely free.
Yeah.
In working trials, the first stake is CD, which is CDX, which is a companion dog stake, which is no tracking. It consists of heel work, retrieve, recall, 3 foot clear, 9 foot long jump, 6 foot scale. Then you do a send away, what they call a send away. The judge will put a marker out, and this can be about 50 yards, and you've got your dog from the pole that's indicated to the point in the hedge. Then the first tracking stake is UD's utility dog. This is a half an hour and it's no less than half a mile long. There is two articles on the track. The track is laid just by someone going into a field, putting one pole in and then another pole, maybe 10 yards apart. The first pole is the start of the track, and the second pole is the indication of the direction of the first leg. This leg can be 30 yards to 100 yards long, and as I say, no less than half a mile. There's two articles on it. Then you do a 25-yard square. The search steward has four articles which she holds from the moment you put your harness on the dog. While you're tracking, she's scenting these articles in her hands. Then she places the articles in the 25-yard square. You don't know what articles you're going to get. You just have to rely on the training you do with your dog to retrieve these articles out the square. Then after the square, you've got to put your dog in a position the judge tells you, and then you get the gun test, which some dogs, like our Patti, is quite nervous of noises, but I'm sure we'll overcome this. Then the next stake is the WD stake, that's the working dog. And again, this is no less than half a mile long, and there's two articles on, and it's the same as the UD, the square, then the heel work and the jumps and the centre bit. TD stake is a little bit different. There's more acute angles, not just straight legs. It has been known for a judge to make a track pattern of 32 legs, and there's three articles on this track, and you've got to retrieve two to qualify. And the same 25 yard search square where you must retrieve two of the articles. But if you're in for the ticket, if you're in the championship, you really need the three off the track and the four out the square to, you know, be in contention for the ticket. In TD also we have the speak, and a lot of people think it's an easy exercise, the speak, but if you've got a dog that is very quiet, it can be a hard 5 marks. But without Patti, she might be frightened of noise, but she loves her speaking. So it's our easy 5 marks. I've trained a number of dogs. I haven't always stuck with the collie. I've trained shepherds, labradors, even a Rottweiler. But I think Patti is going to be a great challenge. I don't always like to have pups. I do like to get a dog with a bit of age about her or him that you can get going straight away. Pups is all right, but you find that you can't, you know, really get to go on with the dog. It is a challenge and you don't always know the background, but if you do your research, I didn't just go to Border Collie Rescue. I tried a lot of the rescue centres, but Nikki at the Border Collie Rescue sorted Patti out. She interviewed me and she knew Patti was the ideal dog, and I'm sure she'll do good for me. I'm really looking forward to going up the stakes with her. She's really, you know, bonded with my other dogs as well, which is important. Yes, we're gonna have a happy life together.
You remember me when the west wind moves upon the fields of barley. You'll forget the sun in his jealous sky as we walk in fields of gold. So she took her love for to gaze a while upon the fields of barley. In his arms she fell as her hair came down among the fields of gold. Will you stay with me? Will you be my love among the fields of barley? We'll forget the sun in his jealous sky as we lie in fields of gold. Move like a lover's soul.